Archers. Archers were amazing.
Going home at 10:40 on Wednesdays. So...
Cameron took going on a run at Tesco's.
I think probably playing football and top field.
Seeing Matt Lane fall into a very deep hole at Reading.
Probably setting my DT project on fire and getting everyone out here.
My favourite memory has got to be in year 10. Axel took a goat into the face.
When I airdropped that photo to Brooke, if you know, you know.
Penwars, in year 9.
Yeah, Penwars. Yeah. Penwars in Craig's room.
Ian throwing up all over me and watching the six slide down Mr. Spell's shiny head.
Free car washes.
Well, in year 9, I walked into the sports toilets and I saw Mr. Archer by the urinal with his trousers by his ankles having a
Rory versus
Menishan
in year 8.
JJ claps
on
the table on rugby tour.
Yeah,
my vocabulary 2016 when I had to be looked after by a few of the teachers.
Surprised you remember that, to be honest, mate.
This one right now.
Reckon physics.
Art.
When I whipped you hard and ripped my skirt.
Naked knee wrestling.
My favourite moments was when we swam at the pools in Delphi and Olympia.
My favourite memory was definitely the creation of the entry.
My favourite moment was probably watching Mr. Craig react to all the toms we put around his classroom. That was us, Mr. Craig, by the way.
The favourite memory was room 14 where Franza lobbed quiche at Cameron Miller's face.
Oh, Nella!
Patrick B. Milburn.
Oh, what's
you
getting?
Maths
clinic. Or getting
sharpened
chin back
for
3 days.
Making all sorts of amazing friends on the back of this car trip.
Maths lessons was awesome.
Probably thousands of girls I've pulled over the years.
My favourite memory, it's got to be when we had a group shower in front of Jack Rothwell. Jack Rothwell, he was so keen, he just climbed in like a good boy into the corner.
Year 10 Rhineland trip.
I walked into the classroom in year 7, chucked my Just Do It bag across the classroom saying, "What's up?" and knocked a light down and paid Chris £5 to hide any
toilets. Feeding pigeons by Lake Geneva and Son.
I'd have to say that cricket banter with the team and of course Mr. Kenwood's catchphrases, that's always been a good laugh.
For us, steering the remote control and changing Miss Morin's projector, and blaming Eugene for it.
Yeah, I'm on the blame.
Matt Chan looking great.
Strangers watching on Matt Lane's sit in Reading.
My favourite memory was probably Cabaret.
It'd have to be Mr. Davies's unkept appendage.
Probably snatching Fajira's wig off in the common room. That was iconic.
Mr. Holleran!
Oh, same!
Mr. Hodes.
Oh, Steve-O.
Miss Johnson.
Mr. Bournet.
Stuart.
Salty Palsy. Mr. Holland.
This year, Mr. Juicer.
Miss Senaratney.
Mr. Holland.
Mrs. Johnson.
Mr. Lee.
And probably Steve-O.
Bowden.
And Miss Orbar.
Oh, Dr. Stuart.
Carol.
Hannah.
Bowden.
You know, Aeneas only talks to us once in the Aeneid. You know that Julius Caesar is never mentioned once directly by name in the Aeneid. You know there are only two epithets ever used in the entire Aeneas. You know!
I think it's probably a tie between Dr. Stuart and Miss Sullivan.
This might be controversial, yeah. For Dr. Bradley, me and her.
Mr. Harding, true patriot. Respect.
Dr. Stuart. Raceless is really fun.
Probably Mr. Silver.
Mr. Craig, definitely.
Mr. Craig,
hands down.
Hands
down.
Year 11 Latin lessons.
Honestly, his dress sense, everything about him.
Fine guy. Poor
lad. Mr. NG.
My favourite teacher is probably Mr. Padfield. He had a really good impression.
Big Danny is by on.
My favourite teacher is Miss Sullivan because.
Just Tom.
Mr.
Diggin,
favourite
knock
I ever.
It's got to be Mr.
Bowen.
Mr. Bowen.
Mr. Bowen.
No, it's Mr. Lake, I'm sorry.
Mr. Bash.
I think he's got Mr. Reed in my ticket shirt.
Mr. Reed in my
ticket. Mr. Reed.
Mr. Haynes is up there as well, I'd say.
Miss Difford is definitely up there.
Yeah.
I have two. I've got my G, Sam Holleran, and I've got Mr. Mulder.
My favourite teacher was
Alright, next question.
Yeah, I mean, obviously I loved all of my teachers, but I think my favourite teacher was my drama teacher, Miss Wheeler.
David Bowden.
Bowden.
Mr. Bowden to you.
So
tables.
That's 50%.
Oliver Randall.
IT block toilets.
That was really.
Nicole and nonce every day.
Pastoral centre.
Probably all the hibs. Yeah, those were great.
Stress, anxiety, the pressure.
The people.
Waking up really early in the morning to spend 45 minutes on my makeup.
One thing I won't miss is Roy's big arms.
Burgundy.
Just the colour.
The overpriced pav food.
I'm not gonna miss everyone roasting you still all the time. I quite like it.
I like it.
Cheese.
Will Carew.
I'll take me, but also Will pretty badly.
It's gotta be Will Carew.
Or William Waller.
Will Carew. Yay!
Hey. Because you got with him.
Yeah, him, bro.
Nah, Roy Noble, come on.
Nah, he's the L.
Yeah. Jack Rothwell.
He takes no questions.
So many, and he's so salty about it.
Yeah.
Jack Rothwell.
Jack Rothwell.
It's got
to be
Jack Rothwell.
Definitely
Jack Rothwell.
Will
Carew.
Afros.
Sale.
Biggest
Sean Gavitt.
Yeah, what?
No, that's a question. Who's the big...
Mo.
Tane.
Definitely Tane, driving into that wall.
Probably been a life prospect over the years. They seem to have declined quite a bit.
Akasacha.
Missed on.
I think I'll miss Peter Lee.
We're going to miss. Please come and help us, Mr. Lee Dance.
Sitting on the field in summer.
Primarily the boys.
Obviously, first, rate that.
Maybe some of the girls. I don't know. Probably not. No, I'm joking.
I want to miss taking the piss out of Harry Potter and Sam Bill's massive foreheads for 7 years.
Lunchtime football. Yeah. Going hungry to get that space in the top field.
The tables in the common room. Chairs.
Yeah. Probably the form times I've had over the years. And the cake days. It's a great as well.
Harry Noble.
Yeah, Harry Noble.
I'm
going
to miss doing this.
It's just really cringy, but just having people and familiar faces around, like, it's cute being able to have so many people you know in life in one place. I won't have that for a while.
I'll miss the bands. There's some funny people here.
The boys and the girls.
It's actually quite a trek to get here. I'm probably going to miss, like, the 90-minute commute.
Egg, tomato and mayo sandwiches.
Probably the alleyway. If you know, you know.
Boys, teachers, some of them, not with them.
All the lovely friends I've made, going to McDonald's at lunch.
The people.
Are we missing the most all of the science work moments with the boys?
Yeah, definitely people as well. Gonna miss it.
My first true love, Jamie King.
Being on report for the last 4 weeks of school.
Toasties, Mr. Haynes, and my friends.
Miss everyone here. I made great friends here.
My friends. And
cheese and
ham toasties.
Yeah, all the
potato waffles and cheese ham. All my friends.
What kind of life?
Oliver.
I'm going to miss being jobless in year 12 because that was so good.
Lucky, I was going to say that. Yeah, being unserious in year 12, like, just not doing work.
Toasties. Full time.
Yeah.
So I think I'll miss most of the people here, but the not place. I'm happy to get rid of the place.
Quite cliche, but I've seen people, like, the family atmosphere is just brilliant, and I'm going to miss everyone a load. And yeah, just make sure we all try and stay in touch. So yeah, good luck to everyone, and all the best for the future.
So Poppy, what are you going to miss most?
Afros.
What's your final message?
Have a sweet life, lads.
Yeah. Make the most of it.
Yeah, nice. Definitely.
What about you? Everyone does the best.
Big love to everyone and Lee Purple.
It's been bad.
If you're deciding whether to come here for sick form, you probably should.
I just, good luck to everyone. Like, I hope you guys get where you want to be in life. Just do what you want to do and have a nice time.
you all mean the most to me. I love you. I'm going to miss you so much if I don't keep in touch with you, which is highly probable, but I will try my best.
Bye.
Put an out.
Well, ladies, fortunately for you lot, I'm still available for prom, so anyone who wants a piece, come get it.
Big love to everyone in our year. Like, it's been a sick 2 years, seven for the ones that were internals. It's been a blessing, and I've been blessed to know.
Good luck to everyone. Love you all. No!
And now, on to the next one. In the words of Mr. Greenwood.
In a bit.
Beating is cheating.
He's better now.
Yeah. Oh, in the words of Mickey, make sure you die with a head full of money. Nah.
Any particular students that have stood out over the last 2 years?
I don't think I could put one particular student. I don't like doing that, but what I would say, I think this has probably been one of my favourite year groups, and I don't just say that because it's you know, you're leaving, but I say that because above all year groups, I think I've had the most interaction. This is my third year here, so I've seen all sorts of different types of students going through it, and I think there isn't a memorable one student that I would take away, but I would take away all of the students that I've met. You've all played a big role in how I've learned how to, even myself, self-development, and how I've learned how to teach, and I thank you for that, and you've all been great.
So, sir, what are you going to miss about this year's Year 13 at St Olaf's?
Unquestionably, Thomas Young's names. No one gave him permission. I certainly didn't come late that long. How dare he take the
final? My memories of this year's Year 13, a lovely bunch of people, good fun. I think my form enjoyed most of my quizzes. And the one thing that I will remember from this year for certain members is that some of them don't know what the word punctuality means. But I wish them all the best.
Right, well, I would like to say goodbye to all the leavers, and haven't we had lots of fun over the years? And you're leaving me now, so stay in touch, come and visit me sometime. Have a lovely, lovely life.
Well, goodbye, Year 13. I hope you manage the exams okay. And please remember that the thing that's going to make you happiest is your relationships with other people, not your exam results.
Three moments, one of them being Garage's stupid questions every lesson. Second one, Chef Time on a Friday afternoon with his incredible knowledge of economics. And thirdly, delivering the Good Life programme to some of you in the year group and your appreciation for it. You're an amazing year group, good luck with absolutely everything. I've really enjoyed working with you at points in the year, and I wish you all the best for the future.
So this is a little something of good luck to all three of my Year 13 classes, who I love very, very much, and actually a quick little shout out to a couple of students. First shout out has to be for my friend Vlad, who we had, I think, too many wars actually about his eyesight, which I hope when he leaves school will finally start to wear his glasses so he can actually see things. Another little shout out has to go to Yasmin and Matt Chadwick, who actually are super hard working, but have also, from time to time, given me a headache. And probably last but not least, Hannah Luca. I don't know whether she's serious or not. I'm still thinking about it now. Is she serious? Is she not? Only life will tell. Anyways, good luck to you all.
Okay, so it's been an interesting 2 years. I can't say that I've been bored any of the days that we've had registration together. I think we've had lots of interesting PSHE sessions, some of them good, some of them not so good. We had our form assemblies, some of which were beautifully prepared, others not so much. Always enjoyed my morning conversations with Yasmin, who was always full of energy, whereas people like myself are not so full of energy. Weishman always brought a smile to my day because of his sheer enthusiasm and zest for life. And I'll give you the same parting words that he gave in the yearbook. Goodbye and good luck.
So reflecting back on the year, I bet you thought I'd never be speaking to you as acting head teacher. Please trust me, I never thought I would be too. I look back at my time with Year 13 and I think of my wonderful Year 9 chemistry class when you were all in Year 9, and also my Year 13 chemistry class that I dumped around about October half term I'm sure they are all missing me. I wish you the very, very best for the future. Be happy, be successful, and please believe in yourselves. For lots of you, your story has not yet been written. Good luck for the future.